The Sumatran orangutan, which is a critically endangered species, lives on the island of Sumatra, which is part of Indonesia. Also living on the island is the Sumatran rhino, the Sumatran elephant, and the Sunda tiger, which is sometimes referred to as the Sumatran tiger, all of which are critically endangered. One of the reasons for these beautiful animals' decrease in numbers is because of the demand for palm oil. To grow palm oil, deforestation occurs on a huge scale. Their homes and food sources disappear, and what is left of their habitat is opened up to poachers. I have already done a video on palm oil, so please have a look at it for more details. So what can be done to help stop this destruction and to save the habitat of these critically endangered creatures before they go extinct? Well, the Sumatran Orangutan Society has two intriguing initiatives which are helping. In partnership with the Orangutan Information Centre, they have helped restore rainforest in some places that are located within the Loisa ecosystem. The Loisa ecosystem is an area of forest on the island of Sumatra in Indonesia, and is one of the richest expanses of tropical rainforest in Southeast Asia. It is the last place on Earth where the Sumatran elephant, rhino, tiger and orangutan are found within one area. The restoration program is within the Gunung National Park, which is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. In spite of this, illicit oil palm and rubber plantations encroach into the park, leading to a deforestation rate of 1,200 hectares per year. The first step in restoring the land was an educational outreach program, which more than 200 students from 21 schools in the area participated in. The students learned about the endangered Sumatran orangutan and also the benefits from ecotourism. Locals were also informed about the job opportunities that conservation and restoration can bring. These joint outreach efforts were so successful that several parcels of land within the park, previously used for plantation activities, were returned to the park office. The process of restoration then started by chopping 15,000 illegally planted palm oil trees, 5,000 rubber trees, and other illegal crops. Each hectare of degraded land is planted with about 1,100 seedlings of 20 to 30 different tree species. Initially, fast-growing pioneer species are planted, which provide shade to outcompete the blady grass that has grown. They also provide shade from the heat for the slower-growing trees. The degraded soil biota is improved by the leaves and twigs of the pioneer species which have fallen to the ground, which then provides the correct conditions for the new forest seedlings to take root. In the second year, hardwood and fruiting trees are planted, weeds are removed and organic matter is added to the soil. The fruit produced by the pioneer species attracts birds and mammals into the forest, some of which bring with them seeds from plants that they have consumed elsewhere, so helping to regenerate the ecological community. By year three, pioneer trees are providing a forest canopy, helping to create the microclimates for the rainforest to grow, and additional tree species are planted to provide a good diversity of vegetation. By the fourth year, the pioneer trees may be 9 to 10 metres tall, and hardwood and fruiting trees around 5 to 6 metres tall. The trees now provide safe nesting spots for orangutans, and other wildlife such as elephants return to the area. The local villagers who used to run the palm oil and rubber plantations in the park now nurture seedlings, plant trees and monitor the health of new forest growth. So far, 70 hectares of land have been restored, which although small, represents an amazing accomplishment in terms of a change in attitudes and actions. Another fascinating and successful project is that of sustainable palm oil cities. Sustainable palm oil that has been certified by the Round Table on Sustainable Palm Oil has not been grown on land that was cleared of primary rainforest or areas which contain significant concentrations of biodiversity. In March 2019, Chester in the UK was named as the world's first sustainable palm oil city. The campaign to achieve this was launched in September 2017 by Chester Zoo in partnership with the Orangutan Land Trust and the Sumatran Orangutan Society. The aim was to change the use of products from those containing palm oil to ones which contain sustainable palm oil. To achieve the status of sustainable palm oil city, the following had to be achieved. 25 restaurants, cafes, hotels and fast food outlets had to sign up. 5 workplaces that offer staff catering services. 2 of 5 schools, colleges, universities, council food outlets and hospitals. 3 visitor attractions or leisure facilities. And 3 manufacturers or retailers based in the city. So not every cafe or school in Chester uses sustainable palm oil, but it is a fantastic achievement nonetheless, and if many more cities worldwide also achieve this status, think what an impact it could have. Building on the success in Chester, the Sumatran Orangutan Society, which is based in Abingdon just outside Oxford, is now working towards making Oxford a sustainable palm oil city. They are hoping to work with the hospitality and food service sector within the city of Oxford and a 10-mile radius. It would be amazing if more cities around the world took part in this initiative. It would help slow down deforestation and so save a precious habitat for all these creatures that live there. I wish the Sumatran Orangutan Society every success and look forward to following their progress.